Does the world welcome that? Do they believe at long last the United States should be preoccupied with Asia and what change in Asia?
Well, publicly in the Middle East, of course, they'll say that they welcome it. Privately, a lot of folks don't. In Asia, the America's Asian allies have been begging for it. In Singapore, in Japan, of course, in Vietnam, in Indonesia, they've all been saying, look, we want some commitments. Now, it's very interesting.
We're worried about the Chinese. Come be our partner.
But I'll tell you, Xinhua, Chinese state media, came out just a few hours ago and said that the United States, that this new Pentagon speech, America was going to be a bull in a china shop. Now, I can't imagine they meant that intentionally, Asia as the China shop.
Right.
But nonetheless, the Chinese clearly are feeling very, very insecure and defensive about the fact that the Americans are now focusing laser-like on Asia as the key area for security.
How about North Korea?
Well, I can't see how Kim Jong-un is going to run this country. The guy's 28 years old. He's been groomed for less than 2 years. There's been a series of high-level accidents of party leaders, car accidents in the last 6-12 months. I mean, they don't even have that many cars in Pyongyang. This is not going to be a smooth transition. And what concerns me is that in the next month or two, North Korea is going to be relatively quiet because no one's going to suddenly move against this guy, and we're going to forget about it. It's going to leave the headlines, but the transition will not have been affected. This is the world's most totalitarian regime. It's one of the world's poorest, and it's being run by someone that's not going to be capable of running it. That's a massive risk. It's probably the biggest single country risk out there in 2012.
Join us online at charlierose.com.